atomic bomb, one of the most powerful weapons within mankind's arsenal, capable of leveling entire cities, shaking fear into the human mind, with mixed reactions upon its use. Such a destructive weapon within the hands of man, which has also brought about the most peace. But where did such a weapon arise, and for what purpose did it serve? Come, let us address the history of such a mighty weapon. In the atomic bomb and its effects upon modern technology, society, politics, and war. The origins of the atomic bomb arose from a small, ambitious country within Central Europe, Nazi Germany. Researching the effects of nuclear fission, the Allies began worrying about German developments for a superbomb, and hence began their own projects in earnest. Labeled the Manhattan Project, the Allies attempted to weaponize nuclear fission before the Third Reich. However, by the spring of 1945, Germany had already fallen. The Manhattan Project did not end with Germany's defeat, though, and in the summer of 1945, the efforts of the Manhattan Project would finally be rewarded. Codenamed Trinity and adequately covered as an ammunition store explosion, the United States detonated the first atomic bomb. Using plutonium and roughly 19 kilotons in blast, the explosion marked the beginning of the atomic age. The following autumn, President Harry Truman ordered the deployment of two atomic weapons over the cities of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the first public display of these new fearsome weapons in the American arsenal. The weapons, bringing about the end of the World War, created a type of optimism that these atomic bombs would bring forth a new era of peace.
With this bomb, we have now added a new and revolutionary increase in destruction, and even more powerful forms are in development.
However, in only but a few years, the Soviet Union unleashed their own atomic weapons, bringing the beginning of the Cold War and an era of unparalleled fear.
The United Nations meets in anger and shock on the morning the Russians detonated their super bomb. Ambassador Adlai Stevenson sums up the feelings of 78 nations.
As he said he would, Mr. Khrushchev has exploded his giant bomb in cynical disregard of the United Nations.
The rest of the Cold War was marked by policies of massive retaliation, mutually assured destruction and brinksmanship, of which greatly affected public society and brought a great influence into those within the era.
Be sure and remember what Bert the Turtle just did, friends, because every one of us must remember to do the same thing. That's what this film is all about. Duck and cover.
Let's face it. The threat of hydrogen bomb warfare is the greatest danger our nation has ever known. Enemy jet bombers carrying nuclear weapons can sweep over a variety of routes and drop bombs on any important target in the United States.
Mr. President, it is not only possible, it is essential. That is the whole idea of this machine, you know. Deterrence is the art of producing in the mind of the enemy the fear to attack.
Shall be the policy of this nation to regard any nuclear missile launched from Cuba against any nation in the Western Hemisphere as an attack by the Soviet Union on the United States, requiring a full retaliatory response upon the Soviet Union.
From the development of atomic weapons arose a new need for development, deployment, delivery, power, and strength. Innovations such as the heavy bomber, atomic gun, atomic rifle, intercontinental ballistic missile, and hydrogen bomb has only brought the nuclear holocaust closer and closer to fruition. Whilst the Soviet Union has now fallen and the threat of nuclear war has subsided, the lingering effects effects of the atomic age continue to affect us to this day. For some, the Cold War has not ended, and for others, it has just begun.
As long as I'm President of the United States, Iran will not get a nuclear weapon.
Weapons, the Jericho 1, which is now obsolete, had a range of 500 kilometers. The Jericho 2 has a range of 1,500 kilometers. And it's thought a Jericho 3 is now being developed, able to travel around 5,000 kilometers, bringing all of Iran and Europe into its range.
For history has, is, and shall always affect us for the eternity of mankind. And only time shall tell whether the human race shall continue to exist as a species, or whether we shall annihilate ourselves off the face of the planet.